I'm Alexis Van Hurkman, and welcome to Resolve in a Rush, where you'll learn DaVinci Resolve grading and finishing techniques in under 5 minutes. In this lesson, we're going to see how you can use the dynamic zoom controls in the edit page to quickly create push-ins or pull-outs in your timeline. So, in this particular sequence of clips, I've got this clip right here. It's the first clip of the sequence. And what I'd really like to do is to pull out from a close-up of his face, an extreme close-up of his face. So what I can do now in DaVinci Resolve 12.5 is I can select this clip. I can open up the inspector, and I'm going to pull all of this off to the side to give myself a little bit more room. And if I scroll down, I now have a dynamic zoom area of the inspector. If I turn this on, I get the automatic dynamic zoom that Resolve always creates. Now, if I want to see the dynamic zoom controls so I can adjust the dynamic zoom, I have to go down here to this little pop-up in the lower left-hand corner of the timeline viewer and choose the dynamic zoom controls, which I can then turn on or off. So with these controls on, I have a green box that lets me adjust the start point of that shot. So if I want to frame really tight on his face, I can do so. And then a red box, which I'm just going to hide the media pool altogether, a red box that lets me see the end point of this move. So if I turn these controls off, I can actually see the move in action. There's my pull out. It goes all the way out by the time I cut. Now, if I want to customize this a little bit, I do have a few options. I can go to dynamic zoom and I can choose to ease in, ease out, or ease in and out. So if I choose that, this move starts slowly, accelerates, and then coasts to a close. I'm not sure I'm that wild about that ease in, but I do like the ease out, so it's good that I've got different options here. And of course, if I decide I want to invert this move, I can click the swap button. And now I'm pushing in rather than pulling out. But I like the way I had it before better. And for those of you that are Final Cut 10 users, you'll be happy to know that the Ken Burns effect that you have in Final Cut 10 will populate these dynamic zoom controls if you export a Final Cut 10 XML into DaVinci Resolve 12.5. If you want to learn more about Resolve's new features, how to get started in Resolve, or if you want to dive deep into editing and or color grading in DaVinci Resolve, you should check out my library of different training titles at rippletraining.com. I'm Alexis Van Hurkman. Thanks for watching.